What is up, everybody? Today is May 3rd, 2020. Right now, I am heading up the river. Haven't fished there in a while. Honestly, heading there because it's the only place I could go right now with that has a tide that's fishable. It's not the most ideal, you know, fishing tide. It's the middle of the outgoing. So it's going to be the current's going to be ripping where I'm going to be going. But I had to get out and get the skunk off my back. So yesterday I spent, you know, all morning searching for my first northern snakehead, and let's just say the day did not turn out very well. 1,000 plus casts, one hit and one miss on my part, man. And I'll tell you what a heartbreaking day of fishing. But we're not gonna sit on and dwell on it. We're just gonna move forward. So I figured, you know, what better place to go to, you know, catch some fish than the river. I didn't have enough time to catch, you know, grass shrimp today. So I had some bloodworms in my fridge. I had some bunker that I netted, a while back that are in my freezer. So we're going to, you know, throw a rod out for catfish and a rod out for, you know, perch. Hopefully we'll get both those targeted species, but man, I can't get this skunk off my back quick enough. So before we get fishing, check out the rigs we're using today. All right, so here's the rigs we're gonna be using. First, we got the traditional high-low perch rig. I had to start using these pink floats up. I had a handful of them and I'm run low on the, you know, white and pink ones. Today we switched over the hooks, try a Mustad, you know, live bait hook. I like these personally just because the eyelets are so much bigger, and we are using 20 pound test on here because you never know if you get like a striper or a bigger catfish. You know, the 10 pound, you know, leader that I was using on the other rigs sometimes isn't strong enough. Now for the catfish rig, we're using, you know, the old fish finder rig. So I have a 2 ounce egg sinker above my swivel, that way it can kind of slide up and down the line. Now we have 2 feet worth of 20 pound test and a Gamagatsu octopus 3-0 hook. Now why I like this rig, it's very simple to use. By having the weight not attached to the rig, the fish can pull on it and not feel the weight, if you get what I mean. What we're going to be using for bait for this rod will be bunker, little chunks of it. And for this rod, we're going to be using bloodworm. So stay tuned. Let's get some fish. All right, we just got to the first spot. Weather's not ideal. Tide is not ideal, but we're not going to let that slow us down today. let's get these rod holders put in. There we go. All right, so tide is going out. So I'm going to put my catfish rig to the left and then my high-low rig to the right. So there we go, get the catfish line out there first. All right, we're gonna sit that in the rod holder and we're gonna get some bloodworms on this and we'll get going. Now while I'm casting out the bloodworm, why I'm saying that it's less than ideal conditions, for where I'm fishing, when this river, you know, is going like middle of the tide like it currently is, it could be very difficult to hold bottom. And then I'm gonna have to switch up to heavier weights, which is not as fun, you know, fishing with light tackle because you're fighting the weight more than you are the fish. But we're gonna see what happens. Just got both rods out. We got about an hour, so let's make the most of it. Dude, that was quick. As soon as that hit bottom, my bloodworm rod, as soon as I actually sat it in the rod holder, it just had a couple little taps. Now little finicky hits though. There we go, fish on. First fish of the day, baby. Oh man, feels good to feel something on the other end. All right, not a bad start. A little white perch. Now even at this size, the crazy thing is these fish are actually spawning. I mean, look how I could tell. I mean, he got a little excited on my hand, but that's kind of nuts. That's like a 5-inch fish and it's already spawning. We're gonna just get that excitement juice off my hands. Ah, there we go.
All right,
let's see if we... All right, we're gonna cast this sucker out there. See if we can get a few more fish. That honestly was almost instantaneous. The last cast, as soon as I reeled in the tight or the slack out of the line and put it in the rod holder, you know, we already started getting little hits. Oh, something's pulling on the catfish rod, but don't look too big. You could always tell. You see the rod tip? Waiting for it to actually hit again. Just as I say that. Probably a little perch the way it was hitting. We're actually getting a little bit of a tug on the catfish rod, so I'm going to pick it up, kind of wait for the next big hit and see if we can set the hook on it. Fish on. Let's go. Damn, son. Definitely a bigger fish. Whoa. Feels like, I don't know, it feels like a cat the way it's kind of pulling. Oh yeah, baby. Let's freaking go. Look at that cat daddy. See now, that's not a big catfish where I come from, but it's definitely a bigger fish than that last one we just caught. Nice little cat, we're gonna let him go. And off he goes. Oh, perch rod's going. Fish on. Oh, let's go. Let's freaking go. I'm over here playing with that catfish and my other rod's dancing. Oh, my Lord. Are you kidding me? Look at this size perch. Lord, I'm serious. Look at the size perch I just caught right here. That might be the smallest perch I've literally caught on a hook and line. I mean... Oh my Lord, that is one ambitious fish. Boy, I might have to call IGFA and tell them I got a potential world record on hand. Now, what's crazy though, look how small this guy is, and you can see he's spawning. I'm not gonna get my man's way, so we're gonna let him go. Now, that's what we call a 2-for-1 special right there, baby. That catfish kind of tore up that bunker, but it's still usable bait. I'm gonna throw it back out there. These fish are not picky by any means, so I'm not gonna put too much bait out there for them. All right, so we got that in. We're just gonna get some fresh blowworms for that. Yeah, so I walked about 5 miles total, you know, walking in and out of different swamps and parts of the Delaware River. Literally made at least a thousand casts. I had one huge blow up. Literally, snake came under the frog and blew it up off the lily pad. Me being, you know, very green when it comes to freshwater fishing and fishing frogs, and I tried to set the hook right away and freaking lost it. I literally went home. That drive home was like probably the most depressing drive I've ever had. I literally, at one point, was debating breaking my rods over my knee. I was so mad. Because it was like, you do all this research, you put in all this time, you know, you walk all that distance, you have one opportunity and you miss it. So, you know, just happy to actually be catching fish again. I'm not giving up on the snakeheads. I do plan on making another trip up to try and find them. Just wasn't my day yesterday. Now what I'm doing is just cutting very small pieces of bunker. I'm only using a Gamagatsu 3-0 octopus hook. So I can't really cut the chunks, huge chunks that you'd use for like stripers. Plus I find that these smaller baits are actually kind of perfect size because the catfish will just come and grab them and go. Ugh. Only bad thing about fishing bunker, man, is your hands smell pretty gnarly afterwards, but
A lot of people on the channel been giving some tips on ways to, you know, get your hands from not smelling like bunker. Oh, we're getting hit on the perch rod. Didn't look substantial though, so we're gonna let it sit. Yeah, not to harp on the snakehead trip I took, but I'm sure you guys have all felt that feeling before where you put, you know, a ton of time, effort, research, you know, you're all geared up to go and, you know, you do everything that you've been seeing people do and techniques that people use to catch them, and, you know, to get skunked was like the worst feeling. Honestly, I'm not even joking. I can't remember the last time I got skunked. Now, I knew going into the trip I was taking a risk because I'm fishing a fishery that I've never, ever once tried before. You know, a fishing style I've never tried before. But, you know, you live and learn. So I did learn a lot from yesterday. And I do plan on making that snakehead trip soon. Because we are going to get that first snakehead, I'm telling you. Oh, fish on, baby. As I'm here complaining about snakes, you know, and getting skunked, I'm here getting... That actually was a better hit. Feels like a... I was going to say a bigger fish. Definitely is a bigger fish, man. But it is not a perch. It's a catfish. Hey, you know what, though? After yesterday, I'll take catching catfish like this size all day.
Yeah. Let's
keep the line tight. Yeah, now, the only thing I could say positive that came out of yesterday was when I did get to the first spot that I found on Google Maps or Google Earth, I, you know, started throwing this hollow frog, and this old timer pulled up, parked right behind me, comes like right next to me, and I just said hello and, you know, how you doing? And he asked me, oh, what are you looking for? I said, snakeheads. He said, well, you came to the right spot. This is like snakehead heaven, which, you know, that's always a good feeling, you know, that your research actually is correct. You know, I found this spot just looking at the maps and kind of looking at where there was shallow water with, you know, lily pad covers. So that's always a good sign. Fish on, baby. Fish on, baby. Damn, this one hit like a bat out of hell. Now, that is what I'm talking about. That's a jumbo perch. Whoa. Sorry, bud. Ugh. That's what we were looking for. Now, that's a good eating size perch. Unfortunately, I'm not going to kill this guy. I know it's a female. You can see the eggs. See the eggs right there? Telltale sign she's spawning. I don't want to, you know, take her away from her job. So we're going to let this one go. Yeah, we're going to let her go. Let her spawn out. Hopefully keep the population great in this river.
Fish on, let's go. Let's freaking go on the cat rod, baby. Let's freaking go. Oh, we got ourselves another cat daddy, baby. Look at that. Another catfish.
Some people call these trash fish, man, but they're not bad eating. The bigger ones, this size fish, you're not gonna get many fillets off of, so we're gonna let this guy go. But it's a good sign.
Oh, fish on. Oh. Damn. This one hit like a freight train. Oh, look at that. Yeah, buddy. Yeah, buddy.
That's what we're talking about right there. That's a nice looking cat.
Woo!
Man, that's a nice looking cat right there. Look at that. Beautiful cat daddy. We're gonna let him live.
Now, why I really like the rig that I'm using for catfish is the weight slides up and down. So if a cat's grabbing the bait, it can pull the bait without feeling the weight. Now, where with this high-low rig that I have for perch,
when they pull it, they could feel the weight on the bottom of the rig because it's attached to the, you know, the central hook. I've always had great luck. Honestly, that's my rig to go to when I'm drift fishing for stripers, or if I'm anchored up looking for sharks. I love this rig. Once we do get warmer weather and the sharks come in, I'm gonna be showing you some great videos on how to target, you know, sharks. Oh man, look at that. Catfish rod's going. Man, that was literally instantaneous almost. Rod's only been in the water for, you know, maybe a minute, or the line, not the rod. But I think that might have been a smaller one, so we're gonna put it down. Well, I can say this too. Good news is I didn't break all my rods over my knee, even though, you know, I wanted to. I haven't, you know, I can't really remember a time I've been that angry actually after fishing. But it definitely bothered me. I mean, I'm serious. I went to bed, closed my eyes, and all I could see was that snakehead right on the surface just crushing my lure. And it's like, I think that slate's gonna haunt me for a while, to be honest. Now the water temp is much warmer since I last came here. It's jumped up into the mid 50s, so that could also be a sign of why they're moving. The water temperature, is what dictates, dictates a lot of their spawning, a lot of these species spawning patterns. All right, not another perch, not a big one, but it's a perch. It's not that world record, you know, 3-incher we caught in the beginning, another male, if you could see what I mean. But let's not get him out of the water longer than we have to. Getting a hit. Fish on, baby. Fish on. Let's go. Damn, son. Another cat, daddy. Another cat. Man, that was a spunky one. That guy was much spunkier than I thought he was. Time to let him go. Now one of the tips with this catfish rig is you want to make sure you reel in any slack line once you cast, because when you cast, the egg sinker or whatever sinker you're using slides up and down, and if you know when you're casting, it might be 24 inches from the swivel, so you want to make sure you reel in it tight so that your weight's on the bottom and the bait's presented at the right, you know, depth. I was saying earlier, water temperature is one of the biggest keys on where to find fish, because they do move. A lot of people don't think about it. They think, oh well, if you go to this one spot, I caught them here, you know, Monday, they're going to be there Tuesday. That's not always the case. Now, if it's a you know, a resident fish, possibly it will be sitting there. But for these fish, what they actually do is, you know, as it gets warmer, they move further upriver towards, you know, fresher water, you know, much shallower water, so that they could spawn. Now, this time of year is very hard because, you know, there's a ton of fish around, but, you know, where they are is anybody's guess. I mean, I'm very fortunate that the first spot I came to today, you know, had fish. Now, I had two other spots in mind, but I'm catching fish every cast, so there's no reason for me to move right now. If I do move, you know, it'll be a little later if we have any time, but I don't think we're gonna have the time. Oh man, look at that catfish rod dancing. Man, something just tried pulling it off. See now, I might be a smaller catfish because it is pulling, but it's not really, doesn't really bend the rod much. I could feel them on the other end, kind of chewing on it. So I'm gonna wait till I get a more substantial pull. And it did just start raining, so. It is what it is. Rain's not a bad thing, man. Everybody hates the rain. I really hate the wind more than anything, but I'd rather fish in, you know, torrential downpour than downpour. Fish on, baby. Torrential downpour, man, I can't speak today. I'd rather fish in that than fishing, you know, high winds. Woo! Another cat.
Now this one's a lot. Oh, look at him. He is beat up. Look at that. I wonder what grabbed him. Look at that. That looks like a fresh wound.
Man, something that, you know, my guess would be an osprey, because it kind of looks like something grabbed it, like claw marks. I don't know.
All right, we're gonna let this little guy go. Man, nice thing is we didn't lose any bait, so I could just rehook it through the skin. Yeah, there we go. That's a primo piece of bait right there.
Now, this is the time of year, honestly, I break out the cast net and I load the freezer up. Now,
I try my best to not take more than what I need, but, you know, since, you know, a decade ago when they shut down river herring, you kind of have to be a little bit more, find ingenuity in bait. So what I'll end up doing is trying to net bunker when they're coming in thick, milroach, any of those type of bait fish, common shiner, they all work great for catfish. And they're free if you know how to net them.
We're gonna hit.
Fish on, ooh, this feels like a bigger one. Definitely the biggest one we had all day. Man, that's a nice looking cat.
Choo.
Look at that guy, that's a nice size cat.
Choo.
Saying hey to all the YouTube people. All right, let's go.
All right, I hope you enjoyed today's video. As always, if you did like it, comment down below. If you're an avid snakehead fisherman, I will accept any advice you could possibly provide. I am very green when it comes to it, so thank you for that. And as always, if you're not a subscriber, click down below, subscribe to the page. I'll see you guys soon.